Nowadays, when we are developing software, it's very common that we have to interact with another apps to exchange data from different data sources. And then it's important to know how to handle data that are delivered in different patterns. And one of most common patterns are the XML documents. So in this video, we are going to see how we can handle XML documents to interact with an object-oriented programming language. So in this case, using Java, we are going to see how we can produce one XML document based in a set of objects, or how to base it in one XML document produce the set of objects in the programming language. So let's take a look here. This is one example of one XML file, basically composed here of a root people tag, and it contains individual person tags inside nodes. Okay, so how we could produce this code using Java? Basically, we have here this method that is using just native Java classes, so you don't have to import anything new to your code, just use these native classes. And it's based in the document object model, the same as we utilized on web programming, for instance. So we have one document, and this document has one root element. So we create one element to be the root tag, in this case, people, that we can see here. And then inside this root tag, we could include child tags, child nodes. And then we can do that creating another element, then setting attributes, for instance. Each attribute we are setting here, they are created giving this output, okay? So we create the attributes, and then we can insert this element inside the root element. So we have the person tag inside the people tag. If we'd like to the person tag to have a child element, we had to do the same, multi-level. There is no limit to that. You can then take this first level, append child, and append a new child, and then the tree is going to be built. Right. So here we create one person tag for this first entry, and then we create another person tag. You can see that here. And add that also as a child of the root tag. So we have both person tags in the first level of people root tag. That's so both variables here is named first level because they are in the same level regarding the root tag that is people. Right. And then the document is created. And here the document basically is ready to be saved, to produce the this string we are seeing here. However, it's just one document object model. It's on memory, so it has to be converted to a string. So how to do that? Basically, that we have then to use this transformer that's responsible to make a conversion of one document to a string. But there are several alternatives to produce this string, several patterns. So we can parameterize the way we would like to have this to be generated. And once it's all set up, we can then use this string writer object to help us to after perform the transform method that will actually receive this document and will transform that. It of course use its adapter, Adum search. And then after transforming that, we are able to take it as a string. And now we can write that in our disk, then generating this output here. We can take a look of this code working. If, for instance, I change this name to uppercase, or better than that, I can just call here to uppercase method, right? So if I change that to uppercase and run the code again, let me close the object. Let's wait it to be processed here. When it's been processed, it's going to print here below. Yes, we can see here uppercase. Let's see the output in the generated file. So here is the file was generated. And you see here, it is uppercase now because it's generated that dynamically. Right. Okay. But then we have seen how to take some objects from our programming language and how to move that, to write that in a file using the XML format. Now we have the second part of this video, how to take this XML document as a plain text file and how to create objects from that. So it's what we do here in this part below. We take the file that was created before, that has this name, that's placed in this directory, and then we are going to parse that to objects. So basically what you do, we construct again the documents using the document object model notation. So basically we have to use this document builder that we have instantiated here. Then we pass the file as a parameter to be parsed, and then the documents here again, but as a document object in memory. Now we have to read information from that. So basically take the root tag and our student, and for all of them we are going to loop them and process them, and we are going to print their values here in the console. So the XML tags, they could have child tags, could have attributes, but they also could have text directly. So it's the case, for instance, here. It could be possible that the person tag, for instance, does not end here, but it could continue to be, just a moment here, it could be continued, and then inside could have here some text. So it's normal that tags have sometimes text nodes inside. So we need to do this control when looping through tags, because sometimes it could have child or even text inside. And then, that's because when we are looping through them, we have to do this identification. It's text, it's another tag, what is that? So we do this control here, and then we are going to read the attributes we have hidden. So we are being able to bring to our program the information for every person we have created here. Okay, so let me run this, let me open the file again, and then let's see the data that are here being printed below in the console, because they are being passed here. Then what we have to do later is just to create the collection of objects, set that in an array list, for instance, and then go on with your object-oriented program. Okay, running that. Let's show it here. And here it is. We can see it prints here to us the tag name, that is the node name here. So it prints here the tag name. The text content is empty. Empty because we have no text inside the tags, we have just attributes in this example. And then it reads the name, where it's programming, it reads the name, the email, and the font. So they are presented here. So here it is one example about how you can use the XML document to be generated by object-oriented programming, how to create objects from one XML file. You can take this whole code to be downloaded, the links below at the video description, and thank you for watching.